If you want to share, if you want to share anything, you can. Now you, the recording starts. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace be upon you. Good morning, good evening, good afternoon for everybody, for our participants and attendees from all over the world. I am Sophia Hawaura, the president of the Arab English Teachers Association. I'm from Palestine. I want to welcome you all and to thank, first of all, the Dr. Muhammad Haiti from Pakistan for accepting our invitation to be with us to give us a nice presentation, which is information. And also, I won't forget to welcome you all, our global and distinguished attendees from all over the world. Now, I want also to thank Mrs. Leila Taik from Morocco, my coordinator in this presentation. Thank you, Mrs. Leila from Morocco. Thank you for joining us. And now you can begin your introducing our guest speaker.
Hey, assalamu alaikum. Good morning, good afternoon, everybody, and good evening to all educators around the world who are with us today in the Arab Teaching Association. I'm very pleased to be here. I'm Leila Taik from Morocco, a MI expert and communicative skills coordinator. I'm very happy to moderate this. Today, we have the prestigious Dr. Muhammad Bahati, our guest, honorable guest speaker, a teacher in the Islamia University of Bahawalpur, Pakistan. And he is an ELT expert with 26 years IELTS and TEFL teaching. He has numerous publishing peer-reviewed research journals, delivering keynote and panel speeches at various international forums. And he has conducted and attended scores of ELT workshops and seminars, awarded honorably doctorate in ELT and applied linguistics by an American university, a recipient of National Human Rights Professional Award in 2016 by IHRO Islamabad, Pakistan. He was also awarded Certificate of Pride and Honor by Arab Translators Association. He also was awarded an Academic Excellence Award from ARTA. Welcome, Mr. Muhammad Bahati. You are with us. I give you the floor to start your speech, and we are pleased that you are with us today.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for introducing me so nicely. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. And very good evening to everyone. This is Dr. Muhammad Safdar Bhatti from the Islam University of Bahawalpur. First of all, I would like to thank from the bottom of my heart to everyone who is present right now to celebrate the very first work anniversary of this Arab English Translation Teachers Association. So I am very happy to be part of this association and have given many times my guest talks. So today, the topic of my talk is teaching as a noble profession. Respected audience, we all are the teachers and teaching at different levels. So what we are doing, what we have to do, what I know, I would like to share with you people. Under this heading, we would like to discuss about the who is a teacher, what the teaching is, what are teacher roles, and what are his qualities, and who is an ideal teacher. Dear all, teaching is the greatest act of optimism. It is the process of facilitating learning and passing on knowledge. It is a noble profession that comes with so much responsibilities and duties towards students. Teachers not only teach and impart knowledge, but also inspire and motivate the students for life and take important steps in life. They keep working to boost up the confidence of students and direct them in the right direction. It is a noble profession because it takes course, it takes courage and passion. A teacher must have the courage to do what is right for the sake of his students and a profound feeling for teaching, even if it is exhausting. The core of teaching consists of these basic values: dignity, truthfulness, fairness, responsibility, and freedom. If we talk about the importance of teaching, the first revelation on our Holy Prophet Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the cave of Hira started with the word Iqra, which means read, read with the name of Allah. So teaching is a prophetic profession. It renders social services. It prepares individuals as required for the society. The impact of mind on the mind and character on character. So teaching is an important skill because it allows people to share their knowledge and experiences with others. This helps people to learn new things and develop new skills, and this exchange of knowledge over generations has helped to develop humanity to where it is today. Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world, according to Nelson Mandela. Education refers to any act or experience that has an effect on the mind, character, or physical ability of an individual. It is not an information, but formation. So it is our passport to the future, for tomorrow belongs to the people who prepare for it today. The art of teaching is the art of assisting discovery. In its technical sense, education is the process by which society, through schools, colleges, universities, and other institutions, deliberately transmits its cultural heritage, accumulated knowledge, values which are social, moral, or the cultural, the skills from one generation to the another generation. Who is the teacher? We all are teachers. My dear, a teacher is a person who transforms his knowledge to the students. He is a professional person. He is the kingpin of the teaching process. He is a strong hammer. He is a preacher, a lighthouse, and a groomer. He is a facilitator and mentor, an educational pathologist, psychologist, psychiatrist, and an educator. This is a difference between the trained teachers and the untrained teachers. The trained teachers are always costly, while the untrained teachers cost more. The trained teachers are fair and impartial, while the untrained are biased. The trained are imaginative and stimulating, while the untrained are dull and boring. The trained are sympathetic, and the untrained are bossy. Trained are constructive, untrained are destructive. The trained teachers are the motivators, while the untrained teachers are the skippers. So in my point of view, good teachers make good institutes, and good institutes make good teachers. These are some qualities of a good teacher: effective communication and good listening skills, empathy, patience, engaging, passion, knowledge, collaborative, prepared, classroom management, leadership, motivational, lifelong learners, creativity, and adaptability. The most important quality of a good teacher is, basically, teachers nurture the potential in every learner. They play a vital role in our society, but their role keeps expanding to meet the changing needs of our society. They add to the cultural and economic aspects of the society. They prepare young people to be active citizens and independent lifelong learners, and this is crucial for their employment opportunities. So the most important quality of a good teacher is the ability to develop relationships with his students. This involves creating a safe and supportive environment in which students feel comfortable taking risks and making mistakes. It also requires building trust and being able to communicate effectively. The role of a teacher is to inspire, motivate, encourage, and educate the learners. Learners can be of any age and from any background. However, for the purpose of this guide, teachers serve many roles. They can be, let's suppose the teacher is the facilitator. He is the mentor and the learning facilitator. He is a role model, on the job role model and teaching role model. Information provider, as a lecturer and clinical or practical teacher, as a resource developer, resource material creator and study guide producer, as a planner, curriculum planner and course organizer, as the assessor, student assessor and curriculum evaluator. A professional teacher has professional knowledge and skills gained through formal preparation and experience. Teachers provide personal caring service to students by diagnosing their needs and by planning, selecting and using methods and evaluation procedures designed to promote learning. Teaching is really rewarding. It is satisfying to see children progress both academically and non-academically as rounded people and future citizens. Teachers might not realize it, but they are the children's role model. A good teacher is someone who can engage his students in learning, make them excited about learning, and help them understand the material. He must be passionate about teaching and helping students learn. They must also be patient and able to adapt to different situations. A professional teacher knows the needs of his students' overall development that can be the physical, mental, and spiritual. He has a command over his subject, transforms raw material into productive citizens of the society, has specialized knowledge of curriculum, assessment, and classroom management. He teaches according to the mental ability. He promotes questioning. He gives examples from practical life. He repeats the answer, and he is a code of ethics. Basically, my dear, this is the real education. We have to instill on children and the students to basically serve the humanity. How to serve them? How to respect the elders one? This is the character building. Basically, that is our real purpose of real education. Before leaving, I would like to give you some tips for becoming an ideal teacher. Say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi to your students. Your behavior should remain good in the classroom. You have to call the students by names. You give them opportunities to the students to ask questions. Make variations in students' grouping during group discussion. To what extent students remain relaxed in your class? Provide the opportunity to ask questions turn by turn. Take the feedback from students during teaching. Organize activities for the students. Concentrate the relevant topic. Determine the objectives of the topic. Make self-correction if there is you have made some blunder. Always plan your lesson. Be punctual if you want to see your students punctual. Maintain discipline in the class. Enter the class with good preparation. Check the previous knowledge of the students. Your voice should remain audible in the classroom. Remain well-dressed and neat. Answer students' questions. Say Allah Hafiz and goodbye to the students at the end of the lecture. And thanks for joining me. And any question, please.
Thank you, doctor, for this precious speech and tips for a good teacher and how to deal with the students, since as we know, the students now, they are different from of this today is different from maybe 10 years ago. And we really benefited from all these skills. That's how it is a novel teaching, and a novel teacher, how shall he deal with his and work with his the students.
So nice of you, ma'am. So nice of you for your very appreciation. And really, I am very happy that may Allah give progress to this association. Yes.
Is there any questions that we can please write your questions on the chat for Mr. Muhammad Bahati to answer? Or shall we open the mic?
Yes.
Mr. Shawqiya?
Yes, yes. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Muhammad. Thank you very much for these valuable tips for our educators. And as you said, teaching is a very noble career and profession, and we should appreciate this career and be proud to be educators and teachers, because as you said, the first teacher in the world was Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and he is our model. We should teach our pupils, our students, our learners, whatever they want, in order to create good citizens and good and distinguished leaders for our societies. Thank you another time. And now, if anybody wants to ask any question, please go ahead.
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes.
Teacher
Mirvat Muhammad.
Yes.
She liked the slides a lot, and they are very interesting, as she said. And she wondered if you can share the slides.
Sure, ma'am. I'll share.
Oh. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Dr. Muhammad Bahati. Yes, we are reading here the chat. Okay. Yes, please, if you have any question, you write in the chat, or you are invited
Hello.
To open. Yes, please. What's your name? Hello. Hello.
Khalid Ibrahim Muhammad, supervisor of English language, Oman.
Welcome.
Paris, thank you very much, Dr.
Where are
Muhammad.
You from, Mr. Khalid? Where are you from?
Yes, from Sudan, yes.
From Sudan. Marhaba.
Yes.
Welcome. Assalamu alaikum. Yes, alaikum. You have some question to ask Dr. Muhammad Bahati?
Yes. Yes, let me first thank Mr. Dr. Muhammad for his excellent presentation, of course, very informative and to the point. And I like very much the qualities of good teacher. This is just like a map for supervisors, particularly to follow for example, choosing teachers, recruiting teachers, and doing other things for them. I also like the role of the teacher is very clear. And my question is that Dr. Muhammad is very creative and he knows a lot. I just want, how can a teacher develop independent or autonomous learning in the learners? That's the question. It might be a very broad scope, but we want your ideas and information. Thank you very much. And thank you again for this important session. Thank you, and Kudushu.
Thank you very much, sir, for your very nice appreciation. And I can't understand your question. Whether you are asking any questions, sir? What was your question?
Yes, his question
is how, he said, how can, how, for example, a teacher develop autonomous learning for students, independent learning?
Part can of, you write it in the chat box, sir?
Yeah.
Yes, he said, how can the current educator now, or the teacher, develop the students? That's the now we know the student now with the new characteristics of today, the students of the today, and his question of Mr. Khalid from Sudan, how can a teacher develop the students.
Right. How the teacher can develop independent learning? Okay, sir, that is a very interesting question. Again, it depends on the teacher, because I was giving you an example of and the difference between the trained and the untrained teacher. So if the teachers are trained, they are updated, they can handle the students, they can make them the independent learner. How? There must be some pair work, proper pairing and sharing, and afterwards you will have to make their groups. And when you are going to assign their groups, the groups must be changed on the daily basis or the weekly basis. And when they will be going to share their knowledge with one another, the teacher should keep an eye on them and listen to them, what they are doing, what they are saying. In this way, they can become independent learners. First, most important thing is that we have to give them some inner interest towards their learning. We have to motivate them towards their learning. We have to tell them what is the cause of their learning. Because again and again, everything depends on the teacher, because teaching itself is very, I was telling you that is a profiting profession. So it depends on the teacher how well he motivates his students, how well he imparts his knowledge onto the minds of the students, and how well he impresses his students as a role model. In this way, they will automatically be active upon the advices of their respective teachers. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now it is very clear. Thank you very much.
So nice of you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Khalid, for your very reasonable question. And thank you also, Dr. Muhammad, for this smart answer. Yes, let's see other educators and attendees here. Please open the mic and ask your question. Okay, I see many people writing in Arabic. You can write your question in the chat in Arabic, and we are going to translate it to Dr. Muhammad. No problem. We'll open your mic and ask your question. By the way, I have a question to you, Doctor. I'm a moderator, but as an educator, I'm curious to also to benefit from your knowledge. Can I have a question?
Yes, please.
Yes. We know that the students of today have certain characteristics. They are smart. They are okay. I put between brackets here smart. Which means I don't mean they are intelligent. I don't say intelligence, because we know that there are different kinds of intelligences. I say smart, like maybe I don't want to compare to a machine, like for example, the mobile. Smart, which means he uses technology everywhere. He finds it on TV. He uses it with the mobile phone, with the tablet. It is a smart watch. And how can a simple teacher deals now in a classroom of four walls deal with that kind of students? Of course, we know that he can use also this technology in that classroom, but you don't see that it will be just boring for him, because he already he is acquainted to these things. How can this is, I think it's a challenge for the teachers of today. Yes, it is a noble career, it is a noble job, but how can this job be as attractive as 10 years ago or 20 years ago, when the teacher was dominant, he was their source of the knowledge? This is my question, Dr.
Bahati. Okay, thank you very much, ma'am, for your very nice question. Actually, as you were saying, now that we are having the digital students, basically. They are the digitalized. They know each and everything. So we have to get the help of blended learning. It can be because recently we were having, all the world was facing the coronavirus issue, pandemic. So we had to take the help of online teaching. Because of that teaching, the students have become the digitalized. They know each and everything. They know all the technologies. But that depends on the teacher, how well he is going to use those technologies in the class. He should get the edge of all those things. All those gadgets, if the students are having smartphone, you can teach them the listening skills with the help of those smartphones. The teacher should devise some clips, listening clips, and I think on to their devices, and then ask them to listen, and then there should be some proper comprehension questions regarding to that. So we everything depends on the teacher. How well is he going to attract his students towards himself, towards herself, and towards his or her teaching? So the students can never learn from you until unless they are not attracted by you. You must be create some attraction with the help of some aviates. You should bring some aviates to the class. If they know all these things, no issue. You should bring the multimedia with you. You will have to give that multimedia. You will deliver your lecture with the help of multimedia. That will be helpful for them, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Bahati. Yes, I think so also.
Yes,
maybe,
thank you.
Yes.
Can I ask a question?
Yes please.
Yes, Mr.
Yes,
Sophia.
Thank you another time for this informative presentation. Really, it was fruitful and helpful for us as educators. But I have a question. You said and we said also, we say that teaching is a noble profession and we should be, as I said previously, we should be proud of it. But unfortunately, for us as Arab teachers and our students are very weak in English as it is not their native language and it is not their mother tongue, they lack the intrinsic motivation. How can, as an educator, how can I motivate and stimulate my students?
Yes, ma'am. Again, I would like to request you, because all over the world, especially I'm belonging to Pakistan over here, English is going to be taught and learned as a second language. Here we are also facing the same problems. But depends on, I think the everything depends and varies from student to student, country to country. If the student himself or herself is interested in his lectures, whether he wants to learn English language or not, it depends on the English language teacher. He will have to motivate him in such a way that he should be encouraged to learn that language. Because I am also very, as you know, I am working as a IELTS trainer, and most of the students are coming to me for, even I am teaching online teaching. I am having a number of and hundreds of students around the globe who are getting online coaching from me for their IELTS program. So I tell them the importance of this language. First, you will have to tell your student how much important this language is and what is the purpose of learning this language. After that, they will be, I think, motivated and take and show their personal interest to learn this language. Unless you don't motivate your student, they will not be taking interest in your lessons. First, you will have to motivate them, and then you will have to tell them how much important this language is. Then they will be attracted by this language and by your lecture. And the English language teachers, sorry to say, they must be updated and motivated, and they should upgrade their knowledge. If the teachers, English language teachers, are not updated, they are not going to polish their language skills and communication skills, then automatically they won't be able to attract their students. I think you have got your answer, ma'am.
Thank you. Yes, thank you very, very much for your good answer. And I want to add, in order to stimulate them, for example, we can use fabulous, inspiring, motivating strategies and techniques in order to indulge them in the education process. For example, as me, as for me, as an English teacher, I many times use, for example, gamification, use some strategies like the little teacher, like, for example, think, pair, and share, the flip the classroom. And many times my students express their pleasure and their happiness with these techniques as they inspire them, they motivate them. For example, last night I was having, or I was preparing my Tawjih students for an English exam, and I gave them many electronic exams using Nearpod, Kahoot, WordWall, etc. And they began competing with each other. And many times a student said to me last night, my teacher, I did that electronic exam. The first time I got three errors, but when I repeated it, I have no errors. So this is the goal of our strategies, which are up to date in order to upgrade, to improve our students. So I advise all educators to be updated always, to use inspiring and motivating techniques and applications in order to have good students. Thank you.
You're welcome, ma'am. You're welcome.
Thank you.
I agree with your point.
Thank you, yes. Mrs. Shafia. So for
thank
this
you.
Intervention, very we benefited from it too. Here, Amel Dawood asked, can we can simulate? She said, I can simulate my students via matching and satisfying their needs and care for the individuals' differences. It's not a question, but can you, Dr. Muhammad Bahati, reflect on this?
What question is, ma'am? Sorry.
Yes, there are some reflections, not a question exactly questions, but some educators on chat, reflections on the chat. For example, Mrs. Amel Dawood said, I can simulate my students via matching and satisfying their needs and care for in their individual differences.
From their teacher, right? They're not interested in his teaching. Am I right? You want to ask this thing?
Yes, just through satisfying their needs and caring for the individual indifferences. Maybe how can we care for these individual?
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Again, I would like to request you that the teacher will have to create some interesting lessons so that the student's interest may be created. There can be some, Ms. Shakya was saying, we have to get some teaching techniques. There can be some activities, there can be some role play models, and there can be some, you can also ask your students to perform a drama in the classroom. You can assign some roles to them. In this way, they will be showing their personal interest towards their studies, because the English itself is very hectic and boring language. The students don't show their personal interest to learn this language. So it depends on the English language teacher that he or she should make his lessons so much interesting, so much innovative, and so much, I think, eye-catching that the students may show their personal interest, and they should not bunk from their class. They should be in the class. They should join the class, and even they should learn a lot from their teacher. In this way, they can show their interest by the interesting lessons of the teacher. If the teacher himself is well planned with his lessons, then automatically he will be delivering well. The students will be learning well. If he is very, I think the teacher must, depends on the teacher. He should be very friendly towards his teaching, towards his learners, and he should teach them in a friendly way. When the students are thinking that There is not a teacher only in front of us. He is like our friend. He is teaching us in a friendly way. So they will be showing their personal interest. I think so, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you for this interesting and insightful, inspiring answer, Mr. Dr. Muhammad Bahati, for the question of Emil Dawood. Do you have any questions, please? Let's open the mic or simply write your question to doctor. Okay, she proceeded and writes the learning via gaming out of the classroom, going outdoor, doing activities. Yes, right, yes. I suggest too, as an educator, that social emotional learning is has proven very beneficial to our students. And giving them feedback, it's very important, telling them all the time that they are doing great and not correcting the mistakes directly, but trying some ways of making the students be aware of his mistakes or her mistakes. This is good, okay, to make them socially and emotionally inclusive. We include all our students. Okay, thank you, yes, for this very humble and very rich chat that you are writing here. We like your sharing, Mr. Khalid and Mrs. Emil. Thank you. Here, Dr. Muhammad Bahati is still with us, sharing his inspiring answers. Please don't hesitate to ask. They are thanking you, doctor. Let us say thank us a lot. Okay. They say in Arabic, the top of creativity, qimmatul ibda'. They are liking your slides and the presentation you have shared.
So nice of you.
Okay.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you. It seems that it is understandable and it was full of information. Thank you another time, Dr. Muhammad Bahati from Pakistan. And we are eagerly waiting for your nice sessions, inshallah, in the coming months. Thank you another time. Thank you for my coordinator from Morocco, Mrs. Leila Tayek. Thank you. You did a very good job. Thank you another time. And it was a great honor to be with us. And also, thank you all our participants who live with us, those few minutes and get benefit. I hope that they get benefit from these things. Thank you another time and meet you in another session, another guest speaker from another country. Thank you very much and hope to meet you again. Goodbye. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. إن شاء الله نتمنى إنكم استفدتوا واللي ما عبّل